Welcome to
Lkidz Show.
Lkidz Show. Today we're talking all about
worship.
That's right, we're talking about worshiping God.
And let's do a drum roll to introduce him. Okay, so that sounds good. Drum roll! We have Michael Morin here.
What's up, guys? I am the Legacy Church worship leader. I make sure everything goes awesome in service with Pastor Steve in the Dome or at the other campuses. All the planning, all the music, all the ways that we worship here at Legacy Church.
That's awesome. And I'm glad you're here.
Because I'm glad to be here, man.
We have a lot of questions about worship
here
at the Lkidz Show.
We have a ton of questions because you're the worship pro. We're like, okay, we gotta ask the pro. Yeah. So can we ask you some questions?
Let's do it.
Okay, so first question, when should I worship?
Yeah, can you worship at nighttime?
Is there a wrong way? So if I go like this or like this, which one's better?
Now, if I'm not at church, can I worship then?
Oh yeah, so do I need to worship at night or is it better to worship in the morning?
What about in the car? Can you worship in the car? What, or the bathroom even? Can you worship in the bathroom?
Oh yeah, do I have to worship with my friends so they can see me worshiping, or is worshiping alone?
Okay, yeah, guys, those are some great questions. How about I start with just one of them?
Okay, one. Okay, a really good question. Is there a wrong way to worship? A wrong way.
Let's see, is there a wrong way to worship? So the way that I would answer that is, what does the Bible say? The Bible says that we worship the way that we live. And so, if you wanna do the touchdown.
Touchdown.
If you wanna do the hi mom. If you want to do the pizza,
deliver the pizza.
God receives our worship the way that we live, the way that we are. He created us to worship Him.
Okay, so does it matter if I like to keep my hands in, or keep my hands out, or no hands at all? God's gonna still like that?
Well, He created you to worship Him the way that He wants you to.
Oh, I like that. So it's the way we live our life.
We're created to worship.
That's true.
That's cool. Ooh.
Okay, so what about our other questions? We had a lot of questions, Michael.
Yeah, we did.
You did have a lot of questions. Thank goodness I brought a bunch of friends to help me answer them today.
So they can help us. Okay, so that means that you guys need to stick around for the Lkidz Show. It's time for Toss Plane! Yeah! Yeah, that time of service where a toy is going to explain a word.
The word for the day is worship. That's right. All right, everybody, let's get it together and explain what worship means.
All right, dudes, instead of me telling you what it is, I'm gonna show you what worship is. It's when you fist bump to Jesus, fist bump, fist bump, fist bump, fist bump, fist bump to Jesus, just like that. And you just keep going and going and going and going, bro. That is how you worship.
Shack do 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 worship. Shack do 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 worship. Shack do 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 worship. Shark.
Wait. Are you just gonna sing, or are you going to explain what worship is?
Worship shark.
Worship is when you put your hands in the air and you wave them like you just don't care. Ha 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 ha. It's worship time.
Seriously, is anybody going to actually explain the word worship?
Hulk worship. Hulk loves to worship Jesus. Hulk lift hand to worship Jesus.
All right, here now, you listen up there, when you go ahead and do that worship, when you lift up, you lift up your hands, yeah, we're going up and lift them up, yeah, and you sure gotta how much you love Him, yep, and hit that, now you're going down here, and that's how you worship.
I seriously can never understand this guy.
All right, mate, so now worship. Worship is when you show God how much you love Him. And you do this by lifting your fins and getting your dance on, and you can also do it by the way that you live your life. Now, worship is a great way to show God how much you love Him.
And now you know what worship means. You're welcome. Bye.
What's up, everybody? My name is Isaiah.
And my name's Carlos.
Hey, we're here once again with the word of the day.
And today's word is
Worship. Oh, worship. I love that. I love to worship. I think this is going to be the best freestyle yet.
Let's do it.
Are you down? You got the beat ready?
I got the beat.
In the record player in your mind?
I do. It's right there.
You put the needle down. It is ready to play. Let's do this.
All right.
Okay. Check it. Yo, yo, sometimes, you know, I have a rough day trying to figure out the best words to say. Yo, sometimes I feel underdressed. Walking in work, I might feel kind of stressed. Hey, yo, it's like your first kid. Nothing really has to be perfect about worship. You just gotta do it from your heart. Represent Jesus Christ from the very start. It doesn't matter if it's perfect. Doesn't matter if it's all about worship. We represent Jesus Christ every way. I do it like this because this is the word of the day. I'm not stopping. I still keep rocking. Pulling best of the rhymes out my front pocket. Oh, wait. There's nothing in my hand. I just stand with Carlos. We do it like we demand. Yo, I rap with him. We jump all around like we're in a jungle gym. Hey, these are the words I gotta say. Worship, well, that's the word of the day.
All right, guys, we have some of our worship team here with us today.
Yeah, y'all introduce yourselves.
I'm Alina.
I'm Abby.
And I'm Hunter. And we're excited to share a song with you today.
That's right. And we should do that right now. Are you ready, Brian?
I'm so ready.
That's okay, let's do this.
One, two, three.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. That hot blood in my body, so don't stop. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off it. We're in so phenomenally. We like the way you pop it, so don't stop. Under the lights, when everything goes nowhere, eyes and I'm getting you close. Will we move like you already know? Just imagine,
just imagine.
Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Come on, good, 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 good. No, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on, all those things I shouldn't do but you dance, 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 dance. Ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. Can't stop the feeling.
That our worship team is really knowledgeable about worship. So we have some questions for you guys.
They know a lot. Mm-hmm. So my question is there a wrong time to worship?
There is never a wrong time to worship. You can worship while you're pulling up to a fast food drive-thru. You can worship when you're sleeping in your dreams. There's no wrong time to worship.
True. Oh, good. So you're sure, so it doesn't have to be at church or only when I'm here at church or only in a certain date?
Nope, it can be any time you want, any minute, wherever you are.
That's amazing, because awesome. I don't want to miss it.
I know, for real. That's actually really good. Okay, next question. Does the song have to be slow, or can it be fast? Like, can I be getting my jam on? Like that, boom, boom, worship, worship. Or does it have to be slow?
That's a really good question. But it can be fast, it can be slow, it can be medium pace, and you can still worship God.
Ooh,
you can worship God in anything.
All right, so I can be like getting my groove on.
Okay.
You got a good jam spook. Got to like Jesus. Yeah.
Yes.
And then still in the same time. Mm-hmm. Get it nice and slow.
Anytime.
Get it nice and slow.
Sleeping in the spirit.
Sleeping in the spirit. I like that. Okay, cool. We had another question. What was it, Brian?
Yeah. Important question. Mm-hmm. Do you have to have music to worship?
Ooh. You can actually worship without singing or listening to music. You can worship while you're cleaning your room for your mom, mm-hmm. or taking out the trash, or even treating your friends nicely on the playground.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, dude, I had no idea. I thought you had to have music to be worshiping.
I could be worshiping all the time now.
We could be worshiping right now. There's no music playing.
We could still worship.
Yeah, Lord. Whoa, okay, guys, those were some awesome answers, because I know there out there in Lkidz. They had these same questions about worship. And you guys really helped us out. And
thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
You guys are awesome.
And you guys are good
singers. Big round of applause.
Yes, yes. Yay. Big round of applause.
It was a scorching hot day. Jesus was traveling and stopped in Samaria to rest. Under the hot sun, Jesus sat by a well. He was thirsty and hoping someone could help him get a drink. Soon, a woman from Samaria came to the well to draw water. Jesus asked her for a drink. The woman was too shocked to give him water because Jesus was Jewish, and Jewish people did not talk to or hang out with Samaritans. Jesus said,
"It's okay. If you really knew who I am, you would be asking me for water."
"What? You don't even have a bucket. How could you get me water? Hang down into the well by your feet and get water by the handful?"
Jesus could see she was confused.
"Everyone who drinks water from this well will be thirsty again. But I have come to share a living water that will satisfy your thirst forever."
Living water? On a hot day like this, it sounds too good to be true.
"Okay, please give me this living water so I won't be thirsty anymore."
Then Jesus said something she wasn't expecting.
"It's not just water you're looking for. I know that you are lonely and thirsty for friendship."
She had never told anyone about her loneliness. How did this man know this? He seemed like a smart man of God, so she decided to ask him a question that had been on her mind.
"Sir, Samaritans worship on a mountain. Jewish people say we should worship in a temple. Which one is the right answer?"
Jesus answered her,
"That's in the past. Soon, true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, anytime, anywhere."
"I know that Christ the Messiah is coming soon. I'm sure he'll explain the rules to us when he gets here."
"Dear woman, I am the Messiah."
The woman could not believe her eyes. The same man who asked her for water, knew everything about her, and told her she could worship anywhere, was the Messiah. She was so excited to tell everyone that she had met Jesus that she'd left her water jar behind at the well. Because of the woman's story, the Samaritans asked Jesus to stay with them. So Jesus stayed for 2 more days, sharing his good news with them.
Hey, Lkidz, my name is Elijah. When you have questions, I'm gonna get the answers. What's your question?
Hi, Elijah. My question is, why do people lift their hands when they worship?
Good question. Let's ask a grown-up.
Wow, that is a great question. So, when we lift our hands, it's like a form of surrender to God. So when I lift my hands like this, it means I surrender. But in this case, it's a good thing. When we surrender to God, He's able to bless us, He's able to help us, He's able to show us His love, and He's able to just lead us and guide us where He wants us to go. It's almost like, also, like a funnel. So a funnel is like a little device shaped like this. And when you pour liquid into it, or like water, or juice, or sand even, everything that you pour in goes straight down the funnel. So, when we surrender to God, we lift up our hands and open them like this. It's like we're becoming that funnel so God can pour into us. So if I have this bottle, put the funnel in, everything that I pour in goes straight into the bottle and fills it up. So when we lift our hands, we become that funnel so God can pour in His blessings, He can pour in His love, He can pour in His joy, He can pour in His wisdom. All the things that God wants for you, He can pour into you when you lift up your hands and you surrender to Him. So, I hope that answered your question. Bye!
Good answer! Now we know! Before we go, let's dance!
All right, Lkidz, it's time to do some praise and worship. I need you to stand up on your feet wherever you are. It's time to worship with us. Come on. Let's put our hands together and clap.
Here and now, I'm in the fire and above my head. Being held under the pressure, don't know what'll be left. But it's here in the ashes.
Well, Lkidz.
I'm finding treasures. He's making
here, and today we're talking all about worship. So let's break it down. So let's break down worship. What is worship? Worship is a way that we can show God how much we love Him. Just like when you have someone that you love, you give them a big giant bear hug, or maybe you draw them a picture. Just like that, worshiping is how we show God how much we love Him. And you know what? He loved us so much. So why wouldn't we show how much we love Him back? All right, we know what worship is, but how do we show God how much we love Him? You could do this by singing, or by dancing, or what if you don't have music? Well, you can show God how much you love Him by praying to Him, or by how we live our lives. Or you can even draw God a picture. Although I don't know how you'd get it to Him. All right guys, so far we learned what worship is. That's showing God we love Him. We learned how to worship. You can do that by singing, dancing, living your life. There's a lot of ways to worship, guys. But now we're gonna learn when and where to worship. You can do that anywhere. You can do worship on Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and especially on Sundays. And you can worship God anywhere. You can worship Him in the shower. You can worship Him at church. You can worship Him while you're walking your dog. You can worship God while you're coloring His picture. You can worship God anywhere and everywhere. Hey guys, psst. I have a secret to tell you about worship.
Did you know that worship is like a superpower? Wait, let me explain. In Psalms 8:2, it says, "From the mouths of children," that's you, so listen up, "come praises, and it can silence our enemies." From your mouth, it can silence our enemies. And do you know who our enemy is? It's the devil. It can silence him so that we cannot hear him. So that's how worship is like a superpower. It's pretty cool. All right, guys, now that we broke down what worship is, I hope that you guys take these things and really apply them to your life. Remember, you can worship anywhere and everywhere. Show God you love him by your singing, your dancing, or just living your life. Well, that's it for me. Bye!
All right, Lkidz, it's now time for a game, and we are going to be playing Can We Guess It?
Music Edition.
That's right. Okay, so what we're gonna be doing is challenging our worship team. Brian and I are gonna be on a team, and we're going to see who can guess the song first, okay?
That's right. We're gonna play 1 second of a song, and we have to guess. If we can't guess after 1 second, we'll play 5 seconds. Winner is going to get
the top banana.
The top banana.
And man, it feels good to be the top banana, right?
Real good.
It feels good. All right, guys, so let's get ready for round one.
All right, have Hunter from the worship team, and it's time to get round one started. If you know the song, hit the buzzer.
All right.
Let's do this.
Oh, I don't know if I know that one.
Mm. 1 second is very fast.
That's tough. Yeah.
I think I need 5 seconds.
I think I do too.
Okay.
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride.
Is it Be Our Guest?
Yes.
Well done. Well done. Hunter, worship team gets a point. Round one, worship team gets a point. Round zero, what am I trying to say?
Okay.
Worship team one, Lkidz show zero.
Yeah.
That's get what that I was going banana. For.
All right, round two. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right.
Are you ready?
Oh, girl, how born ready. I'm ready.
We'll see.
All right, we'll see.
Well,
I have no idea.
How am I supposed to
that
know
could
with
be
just
literally
that?
Any song.
Okay, I need 5 seconds. Darn.
Okay, 5 seconds. Oh man.
That was 5 seconds?
That wasn't 5 seconds.
It felt like
2 seconds.
Let's see. I don't know.
Can we hear it again?
Can we hear more?
I'm very bossy. Sorry, Abby. I'm gonna try to get it again. Is that song from Sing? The movie Sing?
Hey.
Hero? Or I Need a Hero? Or
I'm Still Standing.
I'm Still Standing is what I said.
I've
not
even
hero.
Seen them.
So since I got the movie, is that a point? Yes?
Sure.
Sorry. I do anything I can
fine.
To get a point. So
I didn't know that one. That
I'm just
going to
say
job.
1 point for Lkidz Show and 1 point for the worship team.
Sorry, worship
Next
team.
Round.
All right, it's round three. This is Alina from the worship team. I'm representing the Lkidz Show. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's cue the music. I don't have it.
5 seconds?
Yeah. Frozen 2.
Look at my hand. It is under your hand. Into the unknown, right?
Yes.
Oh. All right. That means worship team 2,
yes.
Lkidz show 1. Let's go to round 4.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, we're at round 4 and I have Michael here. And I'm gonna beat Michael.
It's not true.
I think it's true. Ready to
My hand's out? Closer.
What? Okay, then that's how we're starting the round. Round 4, let's...
But you have to pancake.
Okay, so... Okay, rule is, we have to pancake smack the buzzers to win. Okay, we're ready for our music.
Let's go.
Let's do this. I'm gonna make a man out of you by Mulan.
Yes.
What? She got that off drums.
Drums.
Let's get down.
Yeah. That's what it was.
It's round five, and it's all tied up.
After
all
this.
The pressure is on you right now, and you're going down.
You will see about that.
Let's do this.
Oh! Woo! No, I know it, though. I
Under
know
the
it.
Sea. Ah. Yeah! All right.
Sorry, team.
And Lkidz show. Oh, there's one more round.
Oh!
One more round.
We
so, worship team has a chance. But not a very good one.
All right, we are now at round six, and I'm here with Hunter, and I'm ready to beat Hunter.
Not gonna happen.
Are you ready to lose, Hunter?
Oh, are you ready to lose?
Oh, I haven't lost yet.
Well, it's about time.
Oh, he's ready to battle. So get your hand here. You ready? The
I'm
first
ready.
You hit the button is
I'm
the
get
winner.
It first.
All right, here we go. Cue the music. That is from Hercules, and it is, he's a hero or? What a hero, or something with the word hero in it?
Zero to hero.
Zero to hero for Hercules.
Nah.
And I got it in the 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
So good job, you lost.
Yeah.
The whole worship team
we tried.
Lost. So that means that the Lkidz show is the winner.
Well, we know music, but not good enough. So I guess you're the top banana today.
So, Brian, I mean, we worked hard for this. We've been training. Yep. We've been watching Disney movies over and over.
I gotta thank my kids for making me watch so many Disney movies.
Yeah, so thank you to our kids.
Gotta
sure.
thank Jesus.
Yes, our Lord and Savior. Thank you so much for just being there by our side.
Okay, you guys won!
That's right, we're the top banana. And guess what, guys? That's it for game time.
That's
Bye!
That's it for game time.
Bye!
Boys and girls, it is now time for a quiz. Today our lesson was focused on worship. Were you paying attention? Let's find out. Here we go. Which is the best way to worship God? Is it A, singing a worship song? B, dancing to praise? C, praying? D, living a life that glorifies God? You have 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. If you answered A, B, C, or D, well, that's correct. All of these are great ways to worship God. Well, Lkidz, that's all for today. Thanks for joining me at quiz time.
Wow, that was such a fun lesson all about worship. Oh my gosh.
It was.
Awesome.
Now, Michael, any last things or tips you want to give us so we can worship God?
Remember, kids, you worship the way that you live.
Ooh, so the way that we live. So by honoring God, being obedient, and just being the light in the world, that's worshiping?
That's the way that we honor God with our lives, and that's worship.
Huh. That's awesome. So let's remember to live for God, because that's how we worship too. And a great way to live for God is to accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior.
That's right.
And Michael, at the end of every Lkidz show, we always give everyone a chance out there to accept Jesus as their own Lord and Savior and begin to worship God for themselves.
That's amazing.
Yeah, so why don't we do this right now, Michael? We're gonna all close our eyes and bow our heads. And at home, if you want to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior to come into your life and to make everything just so much more better, we're gonna do that right now. So join us. Okay, let's close our eyes and bow our heads and repeat after me. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you and we thank you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for me. I believe in my heart and say with my mouth, you are Lord. I ask you to forgive me of all my sin, and I thank you for your love and sacrifice. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen
and amen.
Amen. Amen.
Fist bump. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Boom.
Gotta give it a bye, Mom.
Yep, and a bye, Mom. So guys, thanks so much for joining us today as we talk all about worship and really got to get down to the nitty-gritty of what it's all about.
Good job, Michael.
Yeah, good job, Michael.
We'll see you next time, Lkidz.
Yep, so we'll see you on the next Lkidz show. Bye.
Pound it.
Pound it.